Hello everyone, HPI Guys Model Workshop here, and I want to give you a look at what I'm working on for the Thanksgiving weekend. It's just a quick little build, just to get my fingers back used to doing a lot of weathering, and you know I like ship models, I've talked about them before, and I picked this one up quite a while ago, I've built a couple of them, and what I'm actually working on is the Revell Snap Tite pirate ship. And because this kit is dirt cheap, it's around $13, and you can find it anywhere. You can find it at Michael's, Hobby Lobby, local hobby stores, Tower Hobbies, anywhere for hardly any money. And you can see the different options you have available. When you build the ship, you can snap it all together, you can glue it all together, you can do it with sails on or sails off. I'm going to do it with the sails not furled. I'm going to do it with the sails. I'm not going to use these paper sails that they include because I simply don't like them. They're just white paper and I don't like the Jolly Roger on there and stuff. So I'm not going to use those. I'm going to do it as a model that it doesn't have the sails furled. And they do include some really nice plastic pieces to show you. And I'll show you what I've been working on so far. I haven't started any of the assembly and right now I'm doing the painting and the weathering of it before I start cutting things off the sprues and actually assembling anything, because the painting is what makes this kit really shine. Now what you'll see here is how I have it set up, and I'm going to try to show all of you how this goes. And I'm down here in the basement. The basement is about 50 degrees and it's not the most conducive to airbrushing, but I'm doing all the brushing on this by hand because it's just a bunch of weathering. And you can see it is a nice cold day out there in Wisconsin. It is 5 degrees out there, and so it's not all that warm in the basement. I've got the TV on down here. I'm watching the Bounty while I work on this kit. Let you take a look at some of the parts in here. You're going to see, like, these are the sides of the ship, and these come just a plain black plastic, and it's going to be the same black plastic as this sprue here. And you can see that on there, that's a shiny black plastic. And what I've done is I took just a regular paint tray like this, and I've taken it and I put some acrylic craft paint in there, and I squirt that in there, and then I just take regular old Windex, and I like Windex because it does have the ammonia in it, and I just fill it in there till I have it's a little bit thicker than whole milk. You want to have it as thick as skim milk when you're going to airbrush it, but to dry brush and make your own washes, you want it to be a little bit thicker so that it kind of stays. And what I did to just brighten up the black plastic and make it look at least a little worn was I just started to brush that on here over and over and go back and forth and back and forth and dab it off. And I use old socks and old shop rags and anything I have. And when I do stuff like this, I always lay out an old beat-up t-shirt that has paint all over it already so that I don't ruin the table. And that's why when I give my reviews, my table looks so clean. And it's not because I don't use it. It's because that I always cover it up really well, and then I don't have to worry about it. So I give this a light gray wash, and I've done that to any of the black parts on here, except for the lifeboat here and the wheel. But the bowsprit, the bowsprit supports, the cabin windows here on the back I've done in the gray wash, and the black sides. And once I go in and this all dries up real nice over 24 hours and with an acrylic, it'll dry really quick. I'll go in and detail paint the cannons using a acrylic gold color, and that'll simulate brass close enough to what these cannons would be. And that'll be about it. And then I will detail, if you can see in here, these parts right here, these scrolls, I'll detail those and I'll try to add some detail to the windows. And, you know, just remember this is a snap kit. It's fun, so we don't have to get super detailed with this stuff. And I will also work on detailing the masthead there and giving it some washes, some colors, and decoration on there. And you can see, you know, a little bit closer that, you know, you can see the wood grain on there, and it's just highlighted just enough in the light so that it doesn't look so black plasticky. I did the same with the rat lines. You can see I did the gray wash on them front and back, and that works real well. You know, you make your own wash. A $1 container of acrylic paint will last you years, and it works just as well as the more expensive stuff if you can't find a wash pre-made in the color you like. When you have black plastic on something like a boat, you just want to highlight it a little bit so it doesn't look so toyish. Now, what you see in front of you here is the actual deck of the boat, and it comes as all as one piece. And you could see it there. Now, you see I've got quite a few different colors on here. Now, here and here, I'm done with the washes. I did a light color first, a little bit of a darker color than what I have down here washed on, the brown plastic, and that's how the plastic starts. And so I have that washed like that, and then I washed this up here with another acrylic, and what I did was I took a color called Bamboo, and I also took a Create Effects wash that I got on sale for only $2, and that color is called Basswood, and I did the whole deck with those colors, and I made real light washes and did it over and over and over and over again. And once I had done that, then the basswood wash was on the upper levels. Then I darkened it up a little bit with the bamboo wash, you know, here. And then I went over that with an enamel wash once that had dried. And that's just your basic, another Create Effects wash that I got, a stain actually that I got at Hobby Lobby for about $2 on clearance. They had a bunch of these. And I just used this with a brush, and I've done the top deck and the front deck and the back deck so far. And there's a lot of little detailing that'll need to go into this still. But I did that, and these are done. And all I have to do is give them a flat coat once this dries, and then that's fine. But you can see the lights and the darks kind of come out, and you can definitely see the difference on there. It looks a lot more like real wood, and that the upper decks would be a little darker. And then this area here, I made a wash out of trail tan. And I just did that in the same container with the Windex as before, and slurried it around and got it in there real good, and did the stairs and on the both ends, and did everything here with that. And I didn't get a lot of it on the cannons, because those are going to have to be hand-painted anyways, probably with a toothpick. But what I'll do once this dries is then this is much lighter, and that deck will look a lot lighter. And I will go over it with a gray stain, an enamel stain on there from Create Effects. And it's not quite as dark as the oil and grease stain, and it's more of a gray weathered wood look, and that should look pretty good on there. And the great thing about these stains is they dry really fast, and if they screw up, then you don't have to worry about it. And like I said, that's the plastic I started with, and that's where we are so far. You can see how much better this looks, and then once this dries, I'll come back tomorrow and work on that. So those are some of the things I've been working on. I have already did the final stain on the hull, and the hull is one piece, and you can take a look at that, and you can see how that has turned out. And I'm pretty satisfied with how that looks like real wood now of a hull. You know, I just hold it by the peg here, and you know, one of the handy tools I have are these big clamps, and I just snap onto the peg down there, and I can spin it and turn it and get that all stained up. And I just brushed that back and forth on there and wiped it down and brushed it down, and it's pretty glossy. So all I got to do is just give it a quick spray with some dull coat when I've given it 24 hours to dry completely. And being an enamel stain, I'll probably give it a little longer than that, but who knows? It usually, if I spray it with Del Coat, it's the same formulation, and it won't hurt it. It's not like I'm trying to get a gloss finish on a car. So that, I think that's going to look real nice. That looks a lot better than it did when it was just the plain brown plastic on that difference there. One of the other parts trees here that I've been working on as I go is the furled sails and the masts. And the masts, all the plastic comes in that same color as the sprues. And what I did was I took the bamboo right out of the bottle, and I just dipped the brush in it, and I painted the sails. And I didn't try to, when I painted these, you know, I used a cheap dollar store brush like this that you get in a pack of like 25 of them for a buck. And I just kind of went back and forth and back and forth. And you can see, you know, we'll get in there, you know, a little bit here. You could see that it looks like real fabric now because I didn't go crazy on making sure I filled everything. So a little bit of that brown plastic shows through, and it actually looks like a furled real sail. It's got kind of a stained fabric look to it. You know, it looks kind of beat up and weather-worn. So you get a better look at that. And then I went over with the stain on the brown plastic for the masts, and I put it on there real heavy, so that it looks like a actual wood mast and yard arms and crow's peaks. And those are going to look great on the ship. There won't much I need to be doing with these. All I'm going to do is fill in on the where these ropes are going to be to tie the sails up. I'm going to take a really small, much better quality brush than this piece of junk. And that's when you get in there with your real fine brushes, your quality brushes, and you're just going to put a little bit of a darker color into all of these stripes here. And then if you so choose, you could go back and make an extremely light wash. Very, very, very light wash. You could use the oil and grease if you wanted to. You could use the gray, but I want you to take thinner and really, really thin it down and get it so it's just water so that it fills in the creases here. And you don't have to do that. I don't know if I will. I guess we'll find out as we go. But that's what I wanted to show you guys. I haven't even started any of the assembly on this. I think it's a fun kit. I've never reviewed this on my channel before, but I do think it's fun, and that's why I wanted to work on it today. And I got back from visiting for Thanksgiving and figure I'd play with this. There is a lot of other small detail painting to do. This great piece here comes with it. This is the stand. It's got the Jolly Roger. It's got a treasure map. I don't know if we can get it to focus on that. I mean, because that's asking the camera quite a bit. If it can focus on that, there's a treasure map there. Now, that's going to be kind of hard to detail, but I'm going to give it a shot. And if I screw up, all I got to do is wash it off. And so that's going to be a really nice stand. And for the price, you know, this is a good size kit. It's not tiny. It's not huge. It's fun. This would be anything a kid could assemble. They wouldn't need to paint anything. They could easily put that together. I haven't measured the hull, but you know, I'd say what that's probably got to be about 7 to 8 inches long. So it's not going to be a small thing. And when I get done weathering it, I need to decide if I even want to bother with running rigging down some of these lines. And I might and I might not. It just depends on the mood I'm in. After detail painting all this stuff on the hull, I'm going to detail paint the cannons that are above deck and the cannons below deck. And I've got to weather this. I've got to detail the back windows, the side windows. I've got to detail the crests and stuff they have on the side. So I guess I'll decide at that point, after I've done all this on just a $12 to $13 Snap Tite, if I actually feel like rigging the bad boy up. But I wanted to show you this. And I will continue later with part 2 and show you how far I've gotten. Thanks for watching.